Let's talk about elemental symbols in three scenarios. One where we're reading the periodic table, another where we're looking at isotopes of the same element, and then finally when we're talking about the most common or any ion of an element. So in the beginning here we have a block that I've extracted from the periodic table for the third element, lithium, and we see the elemental symbol or abbreviation, the atomic number, often abbreviated as capital Z, and then here we have the average atomic mass of all isotopes of a particular element. Okay, and so that's reading the periodic table. This mass is not the mass number, because we're not talking about a particular isotope, we're talking about the average of all the abundances of the element that's given. Okay, so when we're talking about isotopes, however, we will write the elemental symbol, okay, so lithium here, and we'll put the atomic number in the bottom left. We'll also put the mass number, say we're talking about lithium 7 versus lithium 6, say, and this mass number is abbreviated as A. And it tells us something. It tells us how many protons plus neutrons there are in a particular isotope of an element. And so if we calculate this, for lithium, we don't even need the 3 here. Now, oftentimes you won't see the 3. We can leave it on there for now. But when we're calculating the number of protons, well, that's given to us. And the number of electrons for a neutral element is going to be equal to the number of protons. But the number of neutrons is going to be equal to the mass number minus the atomic number, or A minus Z. And so here we have 7 minus 3 is 4 for the number of neutrons. So 4 plus 3 is 7 is another way to look at it. So what about if we have lithium 6 instead? Okay, so protons doesn't change. We still stay with 3. Electrons, we're going to stay with 3 because it's a neutral species. And then for the number of neutrons, it's going to be the mass number minus the atomic number. 6 minus 3 equals 3. Okay, no tricks there. Okay, except recognizing that the atomic number and the elemental symbol really tell us the same information. The number of protons is what gives us the identity of an element, and they will never change from one isotope to the other. The number of neutrons can change, which is the violation of Dalton's atomic theory, one of the violations where he says that all atoms of a particular element are the same. Well, isotopes violates that particular rule of Dalton's atomic theory. And then most common ion, if we were to represent this as a symbol, we could say for lithium 7, the most common ion, since it's a group 1 element, is plus 1. Okay, so we might represent this as lithium 7 plus 1. And its number of protons is going to be the same, always 3 for lithium. But the number of electrons, because we've got a positive charge, we're missing an electron. Okay, we're missing an electron, and that's why 3 protons minus 2 electrons gives us a plus 1 charge. And the number of neutrons will not change from the other lithium 7 that we looked at. But with lithium 7 plus 1 ion, the number of electrons changes. We could do the same with lithium 6, and you'll see that the number of protons never changes. That's what makes it lithium. The plus 1 charge will take away an electron, and the neutron number from lithium 6 stays the same. It's mass number minus atomic number. We can do this for any element. Now suppose we're dealing with isotopic abundances, and we say lithium, this is an approximation, is composed of entirely lithium 6 and lithium 7. So we're representing our two symbols that we did above. Okay, in words, the nomenclature here. Okay, we're just representing them in words. That second or the number, the mass number comes after the name of the element. What is the natural abundance of each? So what percentage of each would make up all of lithium if we're assuming that the exact masses of the elements are the same as the mass number and their whole numbers? It's a little bit different than a whole number for reasons we don't want to get into at this time for more advanced courses. However, we can do this using the elemental symbol that I've drawn above. And what this is a weighted average. So the average is going to be equal to 100%, x out of 100, so some percentage of lithium 6, and we'll say 6.0, or we could say even, let's keep it generic, x over 100 times mass A, plus 100 minus x, whatever is left over, whatever percentage is left over, out of 100 means percent, whatever is left over times mass B. And we could keep going if we had knowledge of other isotopic abundances, but given the two abundances that we have above, we'll use this formula. Okay, so let's look at our elemental symbol. 6.94 is our average. So if we plug in 6.94 atomic mass units, or Daltons, is equal to x over 100 times the mass A. So we'll call that 6.00. Which mass you define as the first, it doesn't matter. Okay, you can use either one. We'll choose 6. And then the rest is going to be mass B, which is 7.00. And we're carrying it out to three significant figures because that's what our periodic table gave us. And we're using whole numbers because the problem said to assume that the mass is a whole number, just like the mass number. And when we do this, we can multiply both sides by 100, and we're going to get 694 equals x times 6 plus 100 minus x times 7. Okay, and we can distribute our values, and when we solve for x, okay, at the end, I'm just shortening, working this out from the algebra, but when we finish working this out, we're going to get x is equal to 6.00%. And so that means that if we have 6%, then 100 minus x, whatever's left over, lithium 6, whatever is left over, 100 minus x, is going to be equal to 94%, 0.0 to the proper number of significant figures, or we could say 0.00 since we are subtracting, okay, an exact number, equals the abundance of lithium 7.